Mom. What are you doing today?
Providence Place, owned by the Sisters of Providence, an ideal rental setting for retirees to continue their active, independent lifestyles. We have bright 1 and 2 bedroom apartments, a magnificent chapel with daily mass, restaurant-style dining, and wellness and entertainment programs. Call for a tour, 413-534-9700.
Mom, call me when you're not so busy.
Good morning, friends, and welcome to the Chalice of Salvation, coming to you from the Chapel of the Holy Spirit here in Springfield. I'm your Chalice host, Passionist Brother Terrence Scanlon. Today we hear of a woman and her husband who offer hospitality to the prophet Elijah. Whenever he comes to their city, going so far as to furnish him with a place to stay. Let us furnish a place in our hearts for our Lord to stay. Today we welcome back to our Holy Spirit Chapel, Father Robert Gentile, pastor of Blessed Sacrament Parish in Holyoke, as our celebrant. He is joined by Deacon Wendell Pennell, who will proclaim today's gospel and offer our homily this morning. Our Mass intention is offered once again for the names that have been placed before our altar in loving remembrance of our fathers. And as we do each week, we offer our heartfelt good wishes to all who are celebrating birthdays or anniversaries today and in recent weeks. First, a very happy birthday goes out to Annette Schoenrock of Westfield, who celebrates her day this week. We here at Chalice would like to send our best wishes to our former Chalice colleague, Peggy Weber, and her husband, John, as they recently celebrated their 40th wedding anniversary. Congratulations also go out to Jim and Gertrude Manning, parishioners of Father Gentiles at Blessed Sacrament Parish in Holyoke. Also the parents of our co-worker Sean Manning and his brother Brian, Jim and Gertrude, are going to be celebrating their 60th wedding anniversary next week. And we'd like also to honor Norman and Rita Remillard on the occasion of their 70th wedding anniversary. Wow, isn't that just remarkable? And I might add, they are faithful viewers of our Chalice ministry. Our love and prayers go out to each of these couples on their milestones anniversary. We also remember and pray for those who are ill or homebound, to all who are watching this telecast from your hospital rooms or nursing homes. Please, please know that you're always in our thoughts. We pray for you and all those special people who attend to your needs. We will also remember in prayer this day the names that you, our viewing community, have sent into us for today's Book of Remembrance. And friends, following our liturgy this morning, we'll go back to last summer in a story Rebecca Drake did on Blessed Sacrament's Catholic in Action program, asking you to stay tuned. We now join Fred Marion in our hymn of gathering as we welcome Father Robert Gentile, Deacon Wendell Pennell, and together celebrate the 13th Sunday in Ordinary Time.
A house where love can dwell and all can safely live, a place where saints and children tell how our hearts learn to forgive, built of hopes and dreams and visions, rock of faith and vault of grace. Hear the love where pride speak, and words are strong and true. Where all God's children dare to seek, to dream God's reign anew. Here the cross shall stand as witness and as symbol of God's grace. Here as one we claim the faith of Jesus. All are welcome, all are welcome, all are welcome in this place.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and the Holy Spirit. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, let us prepare ourselves to celebrate this holy sacrament and acknowledge our failings.
Came to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call all sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you plead for us at the right hand of the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit and the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who through the grace of adoption chose us to be children of light, grant, we pray, that we may not be wrapped in the darkness of error, but always be seen to stand in the bright light of truth. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in unity, Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the second book of Kings. One day Elijah came to Shunem. There was a woman of influence who urged him to dine with her. Afterwards, whenever he passed by, he used to stop there to dine. So she said to her husband, "I know that Elijah is a holy man of God. Since he visits us often, let us arrange a little room on the roof. Furnish it for him with a bed, table, chair, and lamp, so that when he comes to us, he can stay there." Sometime later, Elijah arrived and stayed in the room overnight. Later, Elijah asked, "Can something be done for her?" His servant Gehazi answered, "Yes. She has no son, and her husband is getting on in years." Elijah said, "Call her." When the woman had been called and stood at the door, Elijah promised, "This time next year, you will be fondling a baby son." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Forever I will sing the goodness of the Lord. Forever I will sing the goodness of the Lord. The promises of the Lord I will sing forever. Through all generations my mouth shall proclaim your faithfulness. For you have said, "My kindness is established forever." In heaven you have confirmed your faithfulness. Forever I will sing the goodness of the Lord.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, are you not aware that we who are baptized in Christ Jesus were baptized into his death? We were indeed buried with him through baptism into death, so that, just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live in newness of life. If then we have died with Christ, we believe that we shall also live with him. We know that Christ, raised from the dead, dies no more. Death no longer has power over him. As to his death, he died to sin once and for all. As to his life, he lives for God. Consequently, you too must think of yourselves as dead to sin and living for God in Christ Jesus. The word of the Lord.
Announce the praises of him who called you out of darkness into his wonderful light. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
May the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said to his apostles, "Whoever loves father or mother more than me is not worthy of me. And whoever loves son or daughter more than me is not worthy of me. And whoever does not take up his cross and follow after me is not worthy of me. Whoever finds his life will lose it, and whoever loses his life for my sake will find it. Whoever receives you receives me, and whoever receives me receives the one who sent me. Whoever receives a prophet because he is a prophet will receive a prophet's reward, and whoever receives a righteous man because he is a righteous man will receive a righteous man's reward. And whoever gives only a cup of cold water to one of these little ones to drink, because the little one is a disciple, amen, I say to you, he will surely not lose his reward." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Finding our faith, it's a journey. To understand our faith journey, we have to think back to the place it started, in the path we've traveled. For me, I grew up in Ward 1 in Holyoke, the Flats. It was a great place to grow up. It had so many other kids. You could always get a game of baseball, pick up basketball. If you carried a sports game of any kind out into the yard, a crowd would gather in no time. And I can remember a sporting event. It was our indoor soccer tournament at West Street School. About five of us on the team went into Holy Rosary Church just across the street from where we lived. And we had a big game coming up against the sixth graders. It was the championship game of the tournament. Now, we went into Holy Rosary. It was very dark. Only the lights from the candles at the various devotional shrines around the church illuminated the areas. So we went over to one of them, and I followed the lead of one of the other boys as he knelt down in front of the statue. I did the same. It felt strange in a dark church, so very quiet. Now this group of fifth graders, all alone, asking for help in our big game. Now this was the first time I ever prayed in a Catholic church.
and I have come to believe this was the start of my faith journey. Because in that quiet moment in the Holy Rosary, something stirred inside me in that dark church that day. I'm a very slow learner, though, because it took another 29 years before I converted and was baptized into Christ. It was a long and windy road that led me to be in relationship with Jesus. The fact that the underdog fifth graders beat the sixth graders has always stuck with me. Was it a divine intervention? Those fifth grade boys sure thought so. It was a gift, and a seed had been planted. What is your faith journey? How do you come to celebrate this beautiful liturgy of our Catholic faith? Think about your journey. We hear in the readings from Kings how the woman could recognize that Elijah was a holy man of God. She could actually see his holiness. What did she see that made her see God working in that prophet? We have to ask ourselves, do people see the same thing in us? She showed us how we should receive a holy person of God, offering hospitality and a place to lay his head. Do we do the same? I would say this woman was a holy woman. Eliza is so connected to God that he's able to have God's grace pour out onto this woman, and he prophesies that she will have a son by next year. He's truly connected to God and works with God. How can we get so connected to God that his grace and his love can flow through us to others and be a blessing to everyone we encounter on our journey? Now, Paul tells us we grow close to God, so close that we're able to join in the flow of his grace. I call it, and I've heard it called and read a book about it, it's called a divine dance of being connected to our God. I can remember being baptized many years after that visit to Holy Rosary. I was baptized at St. Patrick's Church in South Hadley, standing in front of my own two children who were the altar servers, my family and friends. Now, after that moment of baptism, it's taken me another 23 years to fully understand what baptism really means on my journey. And that brings you up to date on my faith journey. What is your faith journey? What does your baptism mean to you? Do we really grasp that we died at our baptism, died to the world, died to sin, and we rose as a brand new creature, a spiritual being connected in a deep way to the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit? We are all disciples on our journey of faith, our journey back to God. This week, the gospel from Matthew is about the cost of that discipleship, the cost of that journey, the cost of our baptism into this beautiful journey of faith that we celebrate and share each week. Whoever does not take up his cross, whoever loves father and mother more than Jesus, whoever loves son and daughter more than Jesus, is not worthy of being his disciple. This is a very hard to comprehend. But by dying at baptism and rising to new life, we are connected to God in a new and deeper way. By making our relationship with that beautiful Trinitarian God and joining in divine relationship, it will give us the flow of grace that will make every relationship we have stronger and more alive with God's love. Our relationship with God has to take priority over all relationships. That is what this gospel is challenging us each to do. The cross we are asked to pick up and then follow Jesus is our own personal cross. To be able to take on our own daily challenges, our encounters every day, by embracing the hurts and the pain of our own faith journey, as well as others along our journey, as well as caring for those we encounter along the journey, we will come to hold the pains not only that we have in our life, but we can share the pains and sorrows of the larger community, hold them on our heart, and we take them onto our cross and lift our cross up to God, because that's our primary relationship. And we bring our cross each week to God and share our challenges with Him. And that relationship will give us the strength we need to be disciples, the disciples we are called to be. May God continue to bless each and every one of us as we take up our cross every day on this beautiful journey of faith.
I believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for forgiveness of sins. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and a life for the world to come. Amen. We take the opportunity now to pray for our needs and for those in need, trusting in an everlasting goodness of the Lord.
Our response will be, Lord, hear us. For the church, that we may strive to be a visible sign of God's love and mercy in the world today, caring for those most in need of both, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear us.
For all who provide leadership in government, in the workplace, and in the family, that they may shepherd their people along right paths and treat with compassion all who struggle or stray. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear us.
For all who work on the land or sea, farmers and ranchers, fishermen and sailors, and all who work outdoors, that they may always be blessed with the bounty of nature. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear us.
For those most affected by global warming, those without the resources or ability to overcome the efforts of natural disaster and environmental repercussions, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear us.
For those anticipating the birth or adoption of a child, that they may know God's blessing in welcoming a new member to their family, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear us.
For our Father Day's intentions, for all the names that have been enrolled in our Book of Remembrance this day, let us pray to the Lord.
Thank you.
Our faith in you, dear Lord, has carried our diocesan community of believers for 150 years. Mindful of your steadfast presence, we commit ourselves again to your wisdom and guidance. From the overflowing springs of your goodness, bless our resolve to serve you and one another. You have always sustained us in the past, graciously accompany all that we do today, and so be with us forever with your unfold and as you unfold our future. Amen. Let us pray that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice of your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. O God, who graciously accomplished the effects of your mystery, grant, we pray, that the deeds by which we serve you may be worthy of these sacred gifts through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks, O Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just. Our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, almighty and eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For through his paschal mystery, he accomplished the marvelous deed by which he has freed us from the yoke of sin and death, and summoning us to the glory of being now called a chosen race, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a people for your own possession, to proclaim everywhere your mighty works, for you have called us out of darkness into your own wonderful light. And so with the angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and the working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. You never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread. And giving you thanks, he said the blessing. He broke the bread. He gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. And giving you thanks, he said the blessing. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. Mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing this sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, Mitchell, our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you, and your compassionate, merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom we bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen, 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 amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we wait the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. My Jesus, I believe that you are truly present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to possess you within my soul. Since I am unable at this moment to receive you sacramentally, come at last spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Let us pray. May this divine sacrament that we have offered and received fill us with life, O Lord, we pray, so that, bound to you in lasting charity, we may bear fruit that lasts forever through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please join me in our prayer for the annual Catholic Appeal. Our faith in you, dear Lord, has carried our diocesan community of believers for 150 years. Mindful of your steadfast presence, we commit ourselves again to your wisdom and guidance from the overflowing springs of your goodness. Bless our resolve to serve you and one another. You have already sustained us in the past. Graciously accompany all that we do today, and so be with us forever with your unfolding your future. Amen. And may the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen. Go in peace, proclaiming the gospel with your lives.
Thanks be to God.
My brothers and sisters in Christ, it's been a difficult week for all of us here in the Church of Springfield. We have heard of the Judge Velez report about the revelations of the allegations against Bishop Christopher Weldon, deceased since 1982. As I heard that report and read it, my heart goes out to the victim, one who came forth after a great amount of discernment and a lot of courage to bring to us his story. I personally have sat with him and heard his story, which was heart-wrenching and heartbreaking. As I speak to you today, I want to assure you that in studying this case, we have learned much in how we as a diocese can better handle any victim who comes forward. I thank Judge Daniel Ford for his willingness to lead the committee that will be a task force in helping us to study the Judge Velez report and helping us as a diocese to best respond in whatever way we can to anyone who comes forward and claims to be a victim of sexual abuse. Over this past year, we have hired 4 investigators who will help us, 4 professional men and women who will assist us in doing investigations into any allegation that comes forward. The 3 district attorneys of Western Massachusetts and myself have signed a memorandum of understanding for a clear way of reporting to each district attorney any allegation that comes to us. As a diocese, we regret what happened in the past, especially in the scandal of clergy sexual abuse. But we have to be resolved that this cannot happen in the future. As we move forward, I ask for your prayers, for your understanding, and for your insights in any way that we as a diocese can reach out to victims and can help them in the healing process. Jesus, the great healer, comes to give us inspiration and help, especially in times of darkness and pain. We rely on the Lord Jesus, his Blessed Mother, and the saints to help us in these days ahead, in these months and weeks, as we seek to be a church of healing and of hope. Thank you, and God bless you.
Hi, Mom. What are you doing today?
Providence Place, owned by the Sisters of Providence, an ideal rental setting for retirees to continue their active, independent lifestyles. We have bright 1 and 2 bedroom apartments, a magnificent chapel with daily mass, restaurant-style dining, and wellness and entertainment programs. Call for a tour, 413-534-9700.
Mom, call me when you're not so busy.
Our family is made up of every race. We are young and old, rich and poor, men and women, sinners and saints. Our family has spanned the centuries and the globe. With God's grace, we started hospitals to care for the sick. We establish orphanages and help the poor. We are the largest charitable organization on the planet, bringing relief and comfort to those in need. We educate more children than any other scholarly or religious institution. We developed the scientific method and laws of evidence. We founded the college system. We defend the dignity of all human life and uphold marriage and family. Cities were named after our revered saints who navigated a sacred path before us. Guided by the Holy Spirit, we compiled the Bible. We are transformed by sacred scripture and sacred tradition, which have consistently guided us for 2,000 years. We are the Catholic Church. With over 1 billion in our family, sharing in the sacraments and fullness of the Christian faith, for centuries we have prayed for you and our world, every hour of every day, whenever we celebrate the Mass. Jesus himself laid the foundation for our faith when he said to Peter, the first pope, "You are rock, and upon this rock I will build my church." For over 2,000 years, we've had an unbroken line of shepherds, guiding the Catholic Church with love and truth in a confused and hurting world. And in this world filled with chaos, hardship, and pain, it's comforting to know that some things remain consistent, true, and strong, our Catholic faith, and the eternal love that God has for all creation. If you've been away from the Catholic Church, we invite you to take another look. Visit CatholicsComeHome.org today. Ours is one family, united in Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. We are Catholic. Welcome home.
One of the most important goals in a parish community is involving young people in a life of the church. In one local Catholic parish, 3 middle school students last year initiated a youth group that has brought new life to their parish and community. Rebecca Drake has a story of CIA, Catholics in Action, at Blessed Sacrament Parish in Holyoke.
They pray together. They play together. And together, the members of the Catholics in Action youth group in Holyoke are living their faith through acts of service in their parish and their community.
We like to do like opportunities where we, like for the First Communion, we help out and we do retreats with them and we help them get into the church more. And then they see what the church is like.
The group was initiated a year ago by 3 middle school students who wanted to become active in their parish.
They had approached me during Bible school saying, "Is there any other way we can help in the parish?"
And we came up with the youth ministry. I mean, if they could meet every week, they would. They just love being together and helping each other out and helping out the parishioners, anyone they can.
Known in the parish by their initials, CIA, the youth group's projects have included coordinating a trunk or treat event for children and collecting toiletry items for an addiction recovery program, all with the support of adult parishioners.
Our parishioners here at Blessed Sacrament encourage these kids. They could ask for rolls of cardboard tubes and they'll give it to them. And they love seeing the kids participating in Mass, being the readers, watching them do things with the little kids.
And through their ministry, these young Catholics also are discovering another important part of their faith, caring for each other.
I like that certain of my friends are here and they help support me and I help support them.
Another source of support for the youth ministry has been the pastor, Father Robert Gentile, who says the life of the parish is enriched by the participation of young people.
Our CIA group, our Catholics in Action group, really enlivens our parish. It brings our youth into the parish. And anytime we have youth in the parish, that really brings life, brings energy. And they do so many great things. And it's giving them an opportunity to really recognize what service really is that it's not just about what you get, it's about what you give in life that truly makes life worth living.
A lesson not lost on the young group members.
I've enjoyed being able to be around people who are very happy and very enthusiastic with what they've been doing. The fact that we're all part of the same religion, all love just helping other people is just so fantastic.
In addition to the support from each other and from older parishioners, these young Catholics know there is someone else who will always be there for them.
Bless us, O Lord, and these thy gifts which we are about to receive from thy bounty through Christ our Lord. Amen.
All the faith, it's about us being people, and we believe in Jesus, and that he's our Messiah. And that he's our Holy One.
According to the Diocesan Director of Youth and Young Adult Ministry, bringing young people into relationship with Jesus Christ, along with involving them in the life of the parish, brings spiritual blessings to the entire parish.
And really shows the community that the young people are not just, hidden away and not to be heard from, but really they are the life of the parish. They are the church today. They're not the church tomorrow. They are part of our church today. And we need to see the young people alive and active and involved.
And getting youth involved with a parish, as Blessed Sacrament members have discovered, is as simple as listening to them and welcoming them.
It's great to hear that young people have come forward and say, we want this for ourselves, we want this for our parish community, and the parish has welcomed them with open arms and given them a place and a voice within the community. We want that for more and more parishes.
The Blessed Sacrament parishioners also have received another gift from their youth group, hope.
The parishioners can't stop talking about them and how lucky they feel we have this in our parish, and it gives them hope for the future, that we have young people that are going to be involved in the church and that the church will always be there.
The success of the youth ministry, according to Father Gentile, ultimately is due to the efforts of the entire parish.
It takes a community of believers to instill faith in kids, and I think that's what we see here at Blessed Sacrament. It's not just myself or our director really said, but it's a whole community that really comes together that supports it and gives it life and breath. So it's really an incredible experience.
And wherever their ministry takes them, these young Catholics in Action know who they are following.
I feel like if we pray to Jesus and God, that they'll always be with us in our hearts.
When life is real scary,
a message of hope that never grows old.
When life is scary.
Our thanks to our reporter, Rebecca Drake, for that story. And sadly, because of COVID-19 health crisis, this group currently inactive but anxious to resume as soon as it is safe to do so. What great kids. And from all of us here at Chalice, we extend our thanks to Father Robert Gentile for celebrating our Mass. My thanks as well to Deacon Wendell Pennell for proclaiming today's gospel, his homily, and assisting at the altar this morning. To Fred Marion for providing our music ministry. It's always a pleasure to have Fred share his talents with you, our viewing community. And I'd like to extend my gratitude as well to all who responded so generously to our Father's Day appeal. We greatly appreciate your prayerful and financial support. And we also appreciate your participation in the 2020 Annual Catholic Appeal, which continues. Not only does it support this televised ministry, but also help fund scholarships for families desiring a Catholic education and for their young ones. So please, please help us out and make your donation today at diospringfield.org. And to all who have given us, we send our thanks. And friends, a special live streaming event we offered this coming week as Archbishop Designate Rosansky will celebrate the Chrism Mass Tuesday at 5 p.m. And you can watch it live at diospringfield.org. That's this Tuesday at 5 p.m. on diospringfield.org for the Chrism Mass. Asking you to join us again next Sunday as we welcome Conventional Franciscan Friar Father Joseph Bain, Rector of St. Stanislaus Bishop and Martyr Basilica, as our celebrant. That's next Sunday on the Chalice of Salvation, your weekly spiritual connection. Sending all in our viewing community our love and prayers. God bless you. See you next Sunday, and happy, happy 4th of July to all.